What does love look like in a world where privacy is rare, dating and every decision is shaped by faith? For Amish women, love and marriage unfold within a strict framework of family values and religious devotion. In this video, we take you to uncover how these women experience love, an experience that challenges our modern notions of freedom and relationships. The foundation of Amish love, faith, and community first. In Amish culture, love and marriage are guided by faith and community rather than personal desires. Relationships are centered around devotion, with family and the community holding central roles. For Amish women, marriage is seen as a vow to both partner and their faith. From a young age, they are taught to prioritize serving God, family, and community over personal goals. Courtships progress slowly, often under the watchful eyes of family members or elders. Couples rarely spend time alone before their engagement, with decisions about love being made within the family. Shared activities like farm work or church attendance replace private dates. It fosters trust, a sense of stability, with love being viewed as a shared, spiritual journey grounded in faith and family. It's a commitment that stands in stark contrast to modern dating practices. But what happens at an Amish wedding when love is rooted in such time-honored traditions? The Amish wedding's simple, but with deep meaning. In Amish communities, weddings are typically held on Tuesdays or Thursdays with the entire community in attendance. The bride wears a blue or indigo gown, symbolizing purity and faithfulness, contrasting with the vanity of a white dress. The ceremony, held at home or in a church, is private, free from social media or cameras, and focuses on sacred vows rather than material displays. Afterward, the community shares a modest meal, strengthening bonds between families through faith and tradition. The wedding dress, handmade and practical, may be worn again for church services or even at the woman's funeral, representing lifelong dedication to faith. Unlike modern weddings, Amish ceremonies prioritize simplicity over lavish celebrations and societal expectations. For Amish women, the focus is on spiritual commitment, not outward beauty or status. This tradition challenges the idea that grand celebrations are needed for significant life events, offering a deeper connection to faith and community. Amish weddings focus on spiritual vows rather than grand displays of wealth or beauty. Do modern weddings still honor this, or have we lost that sense of commitment? Share your thoughts and join the discussion. But the wedding is just the beginning. What comes next? Does marriage and Amish life start with privacy and romance, or is it more communal? No honeymoon, but a deep start to marriage. In Amish culture, newlyweds spend several days or even weeks living with the bride's family rather than going on a private honeymoon. This practice, known as broadside or bride time, focuses on bonding with each other and the community. The couple assists with daily tasks like cooking and cleaning, learning to work together and share responsibilities. Unlike modern honeymoons, this experience challenges the couple to cooperate under the watchful eyes of their in-laws, strengthening their relationship and connection to the larger community. Living with the bride's family highlights that marriage is not just between two people, but a commitment to the entire social network. While living closely with family can be intense, it encourages emotional bonding and prepares the couple for married life. For the Amish, this shared experience fosters patience, teamwork, and selflessness qualities they believe are essential for a lasting marriage. Would you prefer this communal approach, or does the privacy of a traditional honeymoon appeal to you more? But the communal living doesn't stop there. What about childbirth in the Amish community? Before we dive in, I have a quick favor to ask. If you're enjoying this, please hit the notification bell and subscribe. It really helps support the channel, and I'll keep making this show better for you. Deal? Childbirth. Many Amish women choose to give birth at home rather than in a hospital, viewing it as an opportunity for community bonding and to their faith. This tradition is deeply rooted in Amish culture, where a midwife, often a respected member of the community, assists with the birth. Nearly 90% of Amish women still opt for home births in the year 2024, valuing the comfort and privacy of being surrounded by loved ones. It takes place in a peaceful atmosphere, without the use of pain relief. Instead, mothers draw on their inner strength and the support of their community. As women embrace these deeply ingrained roles, what does the hierarchy within Amish marriages look like? The hierarchy in marriage, a woman's role in Amish culture. In Amish marriages, the husband leads the household, making important decisions, While the wife cares for the children, home and supports her husband through tasks like cooking, cleaning, and sewing. Though women don't hold leadership roles in church, they are respected for their spiritual influence at home, often teaching children about the faith. The Amish believe that each person's role, including women's, is divinely ordained. While Amish women may have fewer personal freedoms than in modern Western cultures, many find fulfillment in their roles, prioritizing family, faith, and tradition over individual freedom. However, balancing these values with the ideals of independence can be challenging. Some Amish communities are gradually allowing more flexibility for women in family and business decisions, though the extent of change varies. Even in traditional communities, women continue to play a key role in shaping their family's spiritual life and success. The patriarchal structure reflects a broader system of faith and community, where many women find purpose in their responsibilities. In Amish marriages, the husband may lead, but the woman's role in shaping family life is far more influential than many realize. So, what happens when tradition begins to shift? As women carve out financial independence, could the balance of power in Amish families change? Cannot contribute financially. In Amish communities, women contribute to the family income through activities like crafting, farming, and running small businesses. Especially their earnings are considered entirely their own, which is an interesting departure from the typical norms. This financial independence reflects Amish values of simplicity, mutual support, and respect for gender-specific roles. Women often engage in cottage industries, such as quilting and baking, with their income kept separate from their husbands, emphasizing their role as primary breadwinners. Even in times of financial difficulty, a woman can still contribute, but her earnings remain hers, preserving cultural traditions while granting her financial autonomy. But financial independence isn't the only way Amish women express themselves. There are also fascinating rituals that tie them to their values of modesty and faith. The bundling ritual, a strange yet meaningful tradition. In Amish culture, modesty is crucial, and the bundling ritual plays a key role in relationships. Unmarried couples spend the night in the same bed, separated by a wooden board to ensure they remain physically apart and fully clothed. This practice focuses on building an emotional connection, not intimacy. Bundling allows couples to talk, helping them focus on each other's character and values instead of physical attraction. It fosters emotional closeness, preparing them for marriage by promoting patience, trust, and shared beliefs. This practice encourages slow, thoughtful connections based on humility and commitment, in stark contrast to today's fast-paced, attraction-driven relationships. Bundling helps couples form deeper, more meaningful bonds rooted in respect and shared values. But do you think a relationship without physical touch could create a stronger emotional connection, or would it be too hard? Share your thoughts below. Speaking of modesty, how do Amish women express their inner beauty? Is it about faith and humility, or do cultural norms shape their sense of self? The role of faith and modesty in love and marriage. In Amish culture, women's views on love, marriage, and identity are shaped by modesty and faith. They believe true beauty comes from within. Amish women dress simply without makeup or jewelry, as a reflection of their humility. While they don't express individuality through clothing like in modern society, variations in dress or head coverings allow for personal expression, but always within the boundaries of modesty. Straying too far from these norms may result in social exclusion. For Amish women, modesty isn't restrictive, it's a way to focus on inner qualities like faith and service, rather than conforming to societal beauty standards. They see modesty as freeing, allowing them to live according to their values and express their true selves through devotion to others. But what about the more rebellious aspects of Amish life, like Rumspringa? How does this period of freedom influence the way young Amish women view love and marriage? The Rumspringa tradition. Rumspringa is an Amish tradition where teenagers, typically around 16 or 17, are temporarily freed from the community's strict rules. They can explore the modern world by wearing modern clothes, using technology, attending events, and drinking alcohol. The term Rumspringa, meaning running around in Pennsylvania Dutch, is a time for self-discovery, not rebellion. It allows Amish youth to decide they want to commit to their faith or leave the community. At the end of Rumspringa, the teens must choose either to join the Amish church through baptism or leave for a new life. About 90% of them return, while the other 10% choose to leave, often seeking education or careers outside the Amish world. A well-known example is Kate Stoltz, who left during her Rumspringa and became a model in New York City. Rumspringa is an emotional and transformative period, as Amish youth balance the allure of the modern world with their community's deep-rooted traditions. Those who return reaffirm their faith, while those who leave must face the difficult reality of being shunned by their families. Ultimately, Rumspringa gives them rare freedom to make life-altering decisions about their future. Curious about what happens when Amish break the rules? Be sure to like, subscribe, and ring the bell. This next part of the journey is one you won't want to miss. The ultimate consequence for breaking rules. In Amish culture, following community rules is essential. Breaking them can lead to excommunication, which for women means being distanced from faith, family, and community. This disrupts the unity of the Amish, affecting everyone. It isolates individuals to encourage repentance. It cuts off emotional and social ties, including family. This is especially difficult for Amish women, whose lives are tightly connected to the community. The Amish prioritize loyalty to the community over individual freedom. When someone breaks the rules, they must choose whether to repent and return or stay separated. Excommunication highlights the importance of shared faith and unity, with the emotional toll being high as those excommunicated lose their support system. Ultimately, Amish life asks, how much are you willing to sacrifice for unity and tradition? The threat of excommunication underscores the necessity of harmony within the community. While breaking the rules carries serious consequences, there are subtle ways Amish women still express themselves within these cultural constraints. No buttons. Have you ever noticed how the Amish dress in ways that stand out, even in today's world of fast fashion? For example, did you know that Amish clothing, especially for women, doesn't include buttons? Instead, they use hooks and eyes or straight pins to fasten their garments. Why this choice? It's not just a tradition, it holds deep cultural significance. Buttons for the Amish symbolize decoration, which they believe can lead to pride, something that pulls people away from humility and community. Amish clothing isn't only about modesty. Practicality and durability play important roles in these choices as well. Using ties instead of buttons, for instance, makes garments easier to repair and replace an essential consideration for families that often rely on limited resources. This practice not only suits their way of life, but also reflects their commitment to simplicity and functionality. The choices don't end there. What about the way Amish women style their hair? What makes this part of their identity so meaningful? No haircutting. For Amish women, hair is far more than just a part of their body. It is a powerful symbol of beauty, femininity, and devotion to God. According to the Bible, a woman's long hair is her glory, reflecting her commitment to faith. This belief is so deeply rooted that cutting one's hair is seen as defying God's will and violating the community's moral code. Hair is considered a sacred gift from God, one that should be cared for and protected. Women typically keep their hair long and natural, avoiding dyes or perms. It is often styled in a neat bun or braid at the nape of the neck. When leaving the house, it is customary to cover their hair with a head covering. The most common coverings are white caps or bonnets, symbolizing simplicity and modesty. To this day, most Amish women continue to follow this tradition, keeping their long hair as a visible sign of their faith and identity within the community. But hair is not the only way Amish women express their faith and humility. There's also the well-known bonnet. The bonnet tradition. The Amish bonnet, or mutram, is more than just a piece of cloth. It is a powerful symbol of modesty for Amish women. Made from simple fabric, it reflects the Amish belief that inner beauty is more important than outward appearance. By covering their hair, considered a woman's glory, Amish women honor faith and the teachings of the Bible. The bonnet is a quiet signal. Its style, color, and the way it is tied can indicate a woman's marital status, social position, and religious affiliation, playing a vital role in Amish culture. The bonnet has practical benefits, shielding women from the sun, rain, and wind as they work outdoors, in line with the Amish emphasis on simplicity. But Amish customs extend beyond their clothing choices. How do Amish families raise their children, and what role do traditions play in their upbringing? Education. The Amish education system is designed to prepare children for a life rooted in faith, community, and simplicity. It's emphasizing skills that align with their lifestyle. children attend one-room schools where they focus on basic subjects like reading, writing, and arithmetic until they reach eighth grade. Afterward, shifts to adult responsibilities, with little emphasis on higher education or careers beyond the community. Boys typically begin apprenticeships in farming or carpentry, while girls learn homemaking skills such as cooking, sewing, and childcare. Many young women also take on teaching roles in their communities before marriage, but once married, their primary focus becomes family life. The Amish teach science and personal growth through hands-on experience and mentorship from older generations. This approach places the needs of the community above personal ambition, fostering a sense of purpose and connection that is deeply grounded in tradition, faith, and family values. No use of technology. The Amish community is widely known for its strict limits on modern technology, especially electrical and electronic devices. This restriction stems from belief that an over-reliance on technology can lead to negative outcomes. The Amish avoid the temptations of materialism and the allure of expensive and online entertainment, as these things stand in contrast to their core values. They place greater emphasis on nurturing their spiritual lives and dedicating time to family and community. Social media and other forms of mass media are viewed as distractions to faith and family. For this reason, the Amish minimize their use of modern technology, relying instead on natural energy sources like wind, water, and mechanical power to carry out daily tasks. However, there are some exceptions. Amish families may use simple machinery to assist with agricultural or artisanal work, and they accept the use of essential medical devices when necessary to protect health. No electricity. One of the biggest differences between Amish life and modern society is their choice to live without electricity. This is more than a practical decision, it's deeply rooted in the belief that electricity represents an unnecessary luxury, which goes against their commitment to a nature-centered existence. But how does this impact their everyday life? Without electricity, the Amish give up many modern conveniences like radios, televisions, computers, and electric lights. Instead, they rely on oil lamps, candles, and lanterns for lighting, cook using wood stoves, and travel by horse-drawn buggies. However, there are some interesting exceptions to this rule. For example, certain Amish families use gas or diesel generators to run essential equipment like milking machines or refrigeration, which are needed for farming or preserving food. In some communities, electricity is allowed for business purposes, such as powering lights in stores or machinery for production, though inside homes, electricity is still strictly avoided. Their avoidance of modern conveniences goes beyond just electricity. But how do the Amish feel about photographs? What is their stance on something as common as taking pictures? Discouraged from taking photographs. In the Amish community, photographs hold a deeper meaning than just images. They are seen as symbols tied to fundamental values. For both men and women, having their picture taken is something they generally avoid, and this stems from deeply rooted beliefs in humility and tradition. But why do they resist something so common in modern life? According to Amish teachings, posing for a photo is viewed as an expression of vanity, which contradicts their focus on modesty in every aspect of life. This practice, especially common in more traditional Amish communities, reflects their desire to prioritize faith and community over personal image. Yet, there are some nuances to this rule. Some Amish individuals may accept candid photos where their faces are not the main focus, such as in everyday activities like working the land or participating in community events. These candid shots are appreciated for capturing genuine moments of Amish life without highlighting or drawing attention to any one person. And speaking of simplicity, have you ever wondered what kind of toys Amish children play with? Amish toys for children. In Amish communities, children's toys stand in stark contrast to the flashy, modern items seen in stores today. Instead of the latest gadgets, Amish children play with simple, handcrafted toys that reflect their traditional way of life. Have you ever wondered what these toys symbolize? Many are handmade, dressed in Amish-style clothing, and often depict miniature horse-drawn carts or small replicas of farm produce, like vegetable symbols of the agricultural lifestyle that is at the heart of Amish culture. One notable feature of these toys is their lack of facial features. This is more than just a design choice, it holds significant meaning. By giving children faceless toys, Amish parents impart the lesson that outward appearances are not important. This idea aligns with Amish beliefs, where personal images, whether in paintings, photographs, or social media, are avoided entirely. Instead, Amish communities rely on storytelling and shared experiences to pass down their history and values, preserving traditions without visual records. Just as toys reflect Amish values, the community's approach to farming does as well. But have you ever wondered what happens when the entire community comes together to raise a barn? Collective livestock farming. Livestock farming is at the heart of Amish life, providing essential food, income, and reinforcing values like self-reliance, teamwork, and unity. A standout tradition is the Amish barn raising, where the entire community comes together to complete a barn in just one day. Every person, regardless of age or skill level, has a part to play, using traditional tools and their own strength to build the barn without any machinery. This event is more than just construction, it's a celebration of unity. After the barn is built, the community shares a meal, solidifying their bonds and celebrating their collective achievement. The Amish way of life, grounded in faith and tradition, stresses simplicity and resilience. Amish women, despite certain restrictions, still contribute significantly, balancing community duties with their personal strength. These practices, though unfamiliar to outsiders, have helped the Amish survive and thrive for centuries. If you enjoyed today's video, give us a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel. Your support means the world to us. Don't miss the next video that will pop up on your screen. You'll find the next story just as fascinating. We'd love to hear from you in the comments. Which unique destination should we explore next? Thanks for watching, and we look forward to seeing you in our next adventure.